Watson, I'll hold a cab for us. We leave in 5 minutes for the station.
What a gloomy night. It was warmer inside the waiting hall.
Since the station master told us that the train is about to arrive, we should not have to wait very much longer.
Yes, at last.
Attention! The train is arriving at the station. Please stand well away from the platform edge.
I'll take your bags and your blasted archive suitcase. But Holmes, the headlight. It's faded away.
Something is wrong. I can't hear any sound from the incoming train.
Excuse me, sir. Can you explain what has happened?
I don't know. It's as if the train vanished into thin air.
Holmes, say something.
Quick, fetch a lantern and let us take a look.
It's too dark. Only fog and rails, nothing else.
There is no use in stumbling around here at night. We will come back tomorrow. Well, here we are again at Evesham Station. We have a full day ahead. Let us begin our investigation. First of all, let us examine the area where the train disappeared.
This is the place where we saw the train vanish last night.
Railway sleepers. Nothing unusual. A discarded item, possibly thrown from the train. There are no tracks or footprints on the ground. Railway sleepers. Nothing unusual. There are no tracks or footprints on the ground. First of all, let us examine the area where... A discarded item, possibly thrown from the train. There are no tracks or footprints on the ground. The rails have not been touched. There's nothing unusual here. There are no signs to indicate that the train ran off the track, nor are there any other traces. There is nothing whatsoever. There are no clues, but then a negative result is also a result.
Oh, I see what you're getting at. No clues and you're smiling.
Yes, Watson, I do smile on occasion. This mystery appears very promising. This investigation won't be simple. We shall require a map of the region.
Perhaps the station master could lend us one.
Good morning. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Sherlock Holmes, and this is my friend and colleague, Dr. Watson.
Yes, I remember you. I'm Station Master Everett. You were here last night. So, you are Mr. Holmes, the great detective. Will you be investigating what happened?
I shall indeed.
It is extraordinary that an entire train could disappear like that. And to think of all the poor people inside it, the passengers, the driver.
Could you please give us any details about the train?
Well, there was nothing so very special about it. At least not that I can recall. My memory's not what it used to be. However, if you need it, you can have the train composition report. It's inside my office.
I would be glad to have a detailed map of the local railway district.
But of course, please, take the one that's pinned inside the waiting hall.
See you later, my good man.
Holmes, how is it even possible for a train to disappear?
an old locomotive bell. This part is probably from a locomotive. This place serves as a storage area for the station. This map will be useful.
The entire train has disappeared. It's a disaster. The entire train has disappeared. It's a disaster.
whole train just disappeared. It's unbelievable.
The entire train has disappeared. It's a disaster.
A new telegram.
I think we should meet this Mr. Robinson. Here is the train set. A telegraph. A telegraph.
Holmes, how is it even possible for a train to disappear?
According to the train composition report, there was a special wagon. What does that entail?
That's a highly secure car, ordered by a private party. It is generally to carry something of value. Those wagons have iron walls, you know, without any windows. And they're fitted with a complex keylock.
That is important information. Do you know what was inside this particular wagon?
Certainly not. No, that's private. And it's not my responsibility to allot the wagons to whoever.
Was there anything exceptional about any of the passengers aboard the train?
What do you mean? Like officials? I wouldn't know. Oh, but now that you mention it, yes, there was something. There was a message from Bridlington Station saying that the train had been delayed because of an issue with the passengers. But what kind of problem that they didn't say?
That is interesting. You mentioned a problem at Bridlington Station. I should like to visit this station. Could you mark it on the local map?
Of course. It's a suburban railway station. You might take a cab there.
See you later, my good man.
The whole train.
This is an absolute scandal. It's always the same with these rail companies. No respect for the customer.
please calm down, sir. What is your concern?
Concern? What is my concern? I'll tell you what my concern is. Last night, I were on the train, as usual, with my colleague, heading home. Then along came this ridiculous ticket inspector, who started arguing that our tickets were invalid. He made us get off the train, and he was extremely rude about it.
Were you aboard the train that vanished last night?
Yes. I heard that it disappeared. But I don't care because we would have stopped before then anyway. Our tickets were valid and no doubt about it. And then, to top it all, the ticket inspector pushed everyone else out too, except for a bunch of rich. Well, because their type don't need a ticket.
Can you recall anything more specific about this fortunate group?
Well, yes. They were all foreigners. Spanish-looking toffs with snake eyes.
Goodbye, sir. Good day to you, sir.
Good day. To whom am I speaking?
My name is Sherlock Holmes, and this is...
Are you a representative of this damned railway company? Because I have a complaint.
We are not from the railway company. We are...
Well, in that case, Mr. Shamrock Flomes, please excuse me, but I'm not in the mood for idle chit-chat at the moment.
You must be Mr. Robinson, is that correct?
Yes.
I am leading the investigation of the disappearing train. It would help if you could answer my questions.
Ah, well, all right. I have nothing to hide.
I presume it was you who placed the order for the special wagon.
Yes. It was to transport my valuable prototype safely to London. My prototype is a revolutionary device. It is capable of producing electricity. I'm a businessman and an engineer. I had already found several potential customers for my invention. But I was very optimistic about the directors' board who were travelling on the train last night.
You mentioned a directors' board. Which company do they own?
The Chilean Barcazas Company. I had made an appointment with them. Now they are lost, along with the train and my prototype.
What do you know about the Barcazas Company?
It's a large South American company. They showed a great deal of interest in my prototype, and they seemed wealthy enough to do business with.
This revolutionary machine of yours, was it very valuable?
For God's sake, sir. It is priceless. It could change the world we live in. And yet, I was selling it for almost nothing. I am a humanitarian, you see. I do not know if I will ever be able to get over this disaster. I cannot believe that it disappeared with that damn train.
Mr. Robinson, could you please clarify... Were you travelling alongside your prototype?
Yes, I was. But I had to step off the train. And all because of this stupid station master.
I received a telegram declaring that an important person, a Mr. Bromsby, wished to see you in the waiting room. I merely informed you of this.
Mr. Bromsby is a wealthy gentleman. His interest in my invention was truly unexpected. So yes, of course, I agreed to see him. Unfortunately, he wasn't there. I thought perhaps he might have been delayed, so I chose to wait a while. But despite my requests, the train left the station without me.
Absolutely unacceptable.
The timetable is strict. We cannot wait any longer. The regulations require the train to be on time.
You are an idiot. You will pay for it. I will sue you.
The ticket inspector forced all the passengers from the train, except for the directors of the Barcazas Chilean Company.
Good day to you, gentlemen. How may I help you?
Good day to you, sir. My name is Sherlock Holmes. I am investigating the unfortunate disappearance of last night's train.
I see. I'm Station Master Bertram, but my supervisor has not informed me about this. I do not know if...
Do not worry. I have only a few questions. Station Master Everett from Evesham told us that you reported a problem with some passengers last night.
Indeed. This train is a regular line for those who work at Nottingham. But yesterday, everyone was asked to get off the train here at my station. I've no idea why, and it delayed the train. But the worst of it is that now I have to deal with two furious passengers who are complaining about the company's service. They stayed here the whole night. But people do not usually pay much attention to the regulations, you see. There are very strict and clear rules. Paragraph 234 of Article 2G-43 states that in the event of a complaint, you must...
Yes, yes, thank you. I understand. Apart from the passengers disembarking, did you notice anything else that was unusual last night?
I did, and I mentioned it in my report to our higher management on the matter.
What was it?
Sorry, but I can't tell you. The station master's reports are confidential.
Confidential, you say? How long have you been working here?
I've worked here long enough to be quite capable of managing a railway station. I did. And I'm...
What was it? Confidential?
I've worked here long enough to be quite capable of managing a railway station.
Apart from the path... What was it?
Sorry, but I can't... I've worked here long enough to be quite capable of managing a railway station.
What was it?
I've worked here long enough to be quite capable of managing a railway station.
Very Let me speak frankly, Mr. Bertram. Your age and your lack of confidence in your position are quite apparent. You cannot deny that you have only recently completed your studies.
I was at the top of my class.
Listen here, young man. I am aware that you wish to protect yourself behind all these regulations, but I represent the law.
And you are obstructing the investigation of an important case. I would suggest that you cooperate with Mr. Holmes. Think of your career.
Ah, that is... Well, I'll tell you everything. First of all, I scolded the ticket inspector, for it was he who asked the passengers to leave the train. It was not his right to do so. He was very rude. And then, later on, I received a most peculiar telegram from my colleague at Chesterfield Station, the next stop along the line.
What did the telegram say?
Well, that was the peculiar thing. It was almost unreadable. It was full of errors and awfully vague. It was hard to understand if the train had correctly passed that station or not. You can read it for yourself.
We ought to visit Chesterfield Station. We need to confirm if the station master saw the train or not.
Don't touch anything, please.
This bin is full of empty bottles. How could he fall asleep at work like this? Excuse me, sir. Wake up. Ah, his breath. He must have swallowed half a distillery.
And that explains the how.
By his sleeping off the alcohol, you mean? Wake up, please, sir.
What? The 18:72 train has arrived?
Good day to you. We are investigating the disappearance of last night's train, and we should like to ask you a few questions. Were there any passengers who got off that particular train at your station last night?
No, nobody, it seems to me. Although I did not leave my office, so...
No doubt you were very busy.
You don't say. You can't ever get any peace around here. Now you have to send a telegram each time a train arrives and departs.
Station Master Bertram from Bridlington showed me a strange telegram that he received from you last night. It concerned the train, but it was barely comprehensible.
What? He's a fastidious little twerp, that Bertram. I remember everything quite clearly. It was late, and I was tired. But I did my work. So what? There's no need to be so petty.
Never mind. The station master Bertram from Bridlington showed me a strange telegram that he received from you last night. It concerned the train, but it was barely comprehensible.
What? He's a fastidious little twerp, that Bertram. I remember everything quite clearly. It was late, and I was tired, but I did my work. So what? There's no need to be so petty.
You were not tired, you were inebriated. Tell me the truth now, or I shall not hesitate to document your state in my report.
My friend means that you will end up by being sacked from your position.
All right. So I was drunk. I don't remember all of yesterday, to be truthful to you. Please don't go harsh on me.
Holmes, this man has consumed a considerable amount of alcohol. He's not entirely helpless yet, but...
It will not be long before he is. Obviously, his testimony cannot be trusted.
Holmes, how is it even possible for a train to disappear? I had thought that all station masters knew the Morse code, but apparently not.
A telegraph. A fishing advertisement.
This bin is full of empty bottles.
Locked. There is no sense in asking the station master to open it. We shall have to pick the lock. Thank you. These tools were used quite recently. They are still muddy. We should ask about them. These tools were used quite recently. They are still muddy. We should ask about them. You have quite a number of dirty tools lying around here.
Ah, yes. Well, thank you for reminding me. I should clean them. Although, it might be easier to put them outside. Seems it might start raining soon.
I meant, what were they used for?
Some workers come here and borrowed them from me. They wanted to lift the edge of the railway to one of the stations on the line so that the water wouldn't come in too close.
Who were these workers?
Well, they didn't seem to be from the company, but they was fine lads. They invited me to share a drink. And whatever it was, it had a kick to it. They wasn't English. No, I don't believe so. But see, they knew just what a man needed to brighten up his dull evening. Will I ever get any peace?
Holmes, how is it even possible for a train to...
a handcar wheelbase. Interesting. It appears that elements of the same construction were scattered everywhere. Watson, please tell me, do you believe in magic?
Of course not, Holmes.
Then you are of the opinion that a train cannot simply disappear?
Well, we both know that that is obvious. Why are you asking such peculiar questions?
A little patience, Watson. You will understand my point quite soon. So, are you quite certain that you saw the train at Evesham Station?
Yes, of course. We saw it coming. The headlights. And heard the whistle.
But that is it. We didn't see the train itself.
Oh, Holmes, I'm a little confused.
I should use the appropriate object here. I should use the appropriate object here. So, now here we have the fake train that we saw approaching Evesham Station last night.
Doesn't look much like a train to me.
Be patient, Watson, I haven't finished yet. Try using your imagination. Our train requires only a headlight and a steam whistle. We need to attach a headlight and a steam whistle. We need to attach a headlight and a steam whistle.
The train just disappeared. It's unbelievable.
I need something long for the headlight to be attached. I need something long for the
The long pole is now attached. It will allow us to connect the headlight. The headlight is attached. The steam whistle is now connected.
Holmes, what can we do to make the steam whistle work?
It is elementary, my dear Watson. We shall need a fire extinguisher. The fire extinguisher. Now let us see what we have here. First of all, let us pump the pressure inside the extinguisher. The steam whistle is ready to be used. Watson, I do believe that we have created an exact replica of the train that vanished in front of us last night. The criminal mind can be most inventive. I am somewhat in awe.
So, such a thing is possible. If someone went to all the trouble of creating this fake train, then it was surely with the intention of stealing the real one.
Ah, Watson, you should not jump to conclusions. In fact, this does not tell us very much at all, except that the train did not evaporate into thin air.
Although you half suspected it.
Huh. At any rate, we now need to find where the real train might be hidden. I suggest we use my archives to find a more detailed map of our surroundings.
Well, I hope that justifies our having to load your massive archive suitcase onto the cab. It made us extremely unpopular with our driver.
Will I ever get any peace?
Holmes, how is it even possible for a train to disappear? This bin is...
railway post bags. A telegraph. The insurance policy for Robinson's machine. A significant sum. A telegraph. A telegraph.
Don't touch anything, please.
According to this document, you have insurance for your prototype.
Oh, thank God. Where did you find it?
Near the telegraph station.
I must have lost it when I tried to send a message, which I was prevented from doing.
I apologise for that, but regulations state that public access to the telegraph is strictly prohibited.
Upon my word, you keep on digging that hole of yours. You have no idea who I am.
I see that you kept your grip sack with you. Why don't you leave it in the luggage room?
I've had other things to think about. I lost my prototype. And this idiot station master just stands here doing nothing to help.
Oh, but...
Well, that won't do at all. Station master, I believe that the regulations state that any passenger luggage should be taken to the luggage room.
I'll do it right away, sir. Sorry, sir.
This Robinson is quite a character. We should learn more about him. Railway post bags. This grip sack belongs to Mr. Robinson.
I think we should open it, Holmes. This is what they call force majeure. I'll keep watch.
Of course.
Look, Watson. An exclusive sales contract. Yet another exclusive sales contract. Mr. Robinson is the seller. Yet another exclusive. Mr. Robinson is the seller. Yet another exclusive sales contract. Mr. Robinson is the seller. Well, it is very clear that this Mr. Robinson received prepayments from various people for his machine.